Now, in a bid to ensure that coronavirus pandemic is brought under control and halted through increased testing of citizens and residents, the Delta State government has established sample collection centers in the government hospitals across the state, which can easily be assessed by those desirous to know their COVID-19 status. This is contained in a statement on Friday and signed by the State Director of Information, Dona Obuse, which reiterated that sample collection and testing are free and issuance of certificate of result after testing is also free, adding that no account should any resident in the state pay for the above mentioned services. End of quote. That statement is directly from him. And the statement further advised residents to take the opportunity of the free testing program to know their COVID-19 status. Joining us to understand this more is Charles Aniagu, who's the Commissioner for Information of Delta State. Good to have you, Commissioner.
Thank you very much, Amaka. Good morning.
Good morning to you too. Now, so like that, you are offering free testing for residents of Delta. Why have you been able to achieve this? And, you know, when we are told how costly such tests can be, I'm wondering what's motivating this goodwill, if you like?
Well, let's make it clear that from the inception, just like the NCDC has also done, in the state who have ensured that our people don't have to pay a farthing for them to be tested for the COVID-19 virus. But along the line, we discovered, of course, you know, it happens for in every 12, certainly you see Judas. We discovered that some persons are trying to take advantage of our people by asking them to pay someone. I said, no, nobody pays anything to get tested. And even when you are found to have been positive to a very large extent, the state bears the burden of treatment, except those who are in a hurry and then who maybe have the facility to self-isolate and then get the support of the medical personnel, and possibly they may want to, if the drugs are available, particularly the multivitamins in across a counter in a number of pharmacy stores, and then they can go there and augment if the state is not able to or is not quick enough to give them some of the multivitamins that they desire. But in terms of providing the medical attention and support, our health personnel have been up and doing. And so we did say that it's important, because if you begin to ask people to pay, bearing in mind the state of the economy at the moment, it will become very, very difficult for you to have a number of people show up. And when they don't show up, it means that you are not going to find it easy to scale down or flatten the curve in terms of the spread of the virus. And as long as the virus remains, it will continue to deal a dirty blow on the economy of the state and, of course, that of the country.
Right. I mean, how about those visiting Delta State from other parts of Nigeria? So if I'm coming in from Lagos, for instance, or any other place, would they be able to access the free service?
If you are the... Yes, it's for everybody, both those who live in the state. The moment you come in and you want to make yourself available to be tested, particularly those who may fall within the category of exhibiting some of the known symptoms, we subject them to tests. We don't have to charge anybody any money the moment you are in the state. But at the moment, we have gone ahead to start establish a second test center in Oara, which any moment from now will be up and running. Of course, we need the NCDC to come and complete all the processes. It's something that is ongoing. The one in Asaba, through the support of Pandora Health Services and the tertiary hospital in Irua, have been up and running. And of course, we have taken advantage of that to conduct a number of the tests. Yes, this moment, because it's the only one running, you see people going through some delays that are avoidable. And so in order to reduce the amount of time individuals who have presented themselves for such tests will have to wait, we have also gone ahead as a state to set up the second test center. We are hoping that as we make progress, we'll be able to also set up another one. Of course, you know that the lab for the test of COVID-19 is not just like any other lab because of its category. It has to meet certain requirements because it's a place where you don't need the whatever specimen or samples to be contaminated, because when that happens to a very large extent, it will affect the outcome of the result. and COVID-19 is not what you can joke with to begin to say that somebody is positive when he's not, or that somebody is negative when he's positive.
Right.
And so we're putting everything in place, crossing the T's and dotting the I's.
Right. I mean, while talking about that as something praiseworthy, critics wonder why the intervention is coming only at this time. And how do you ensure a monitoring and evaluation of all of these things that you've put in place that it will be working effectively?
I wouldn't know where the critics will be coming from. COVID-19 is not one of those things that anybody, any of the state governments, particularly in Nigeria, planned for at the beginning of the year. Even most countries did not even know that it's any of certain will happen. And so that's why it's still called novel, the novel coronavirus disease. And so because it's something that nobody planned for, you couldn't have budgeted for it in 2019. And so as soon as it came, governments needed to make some adjustments to their budget, because you can't just continue to spend and call it emergency. It has moved away from the emergency table now to now come into different budgets. Almost every state now have effected some form of review of the 2020 budget, because at the time it was being conceived, they never thought that anything of like COVID-19 would come in where it would take a toll on the economy of states. Mm-hmm. Now, having seen that the virus is here to stay for a little while, we have made a lot of adjustments. And those adjustments include this issue of establishing another center for the purpose of testing, just as we also have established a number of treatment centers. You recall at the beginning, a number of states thought that everybody would be needing the ventilator. And so ventilator was the end thing. Today you can see that ventilator is no longer in the news, because we discovered that a number of the cases are usually mild and will not require the services of a ventilator. And so all the funds that individuals and states were deploying to acquire ventilator cannot be saved to now acquire other things that are needed, particularly the PPEs, because the medical personnel will need it continuously. And bearing in mind that they are usually disposable, it means that you are going to acquire as many as possible. Then beyond that, we're also very much interested in strengthening our hospitals far beyond the requirements of COVID-19, because COVID-19, like we have always mentioned, will not and cannot sustain suspend all the other ailments that are known to us in Africa, be they malaria and all other forms of diseases. And so equipping the hospitals to be able to meet up that challenge is one other thing that we're also focusing. Bearing in mind that at this moment that every economy is challenged, we are taking them in our strides, and then we appreciate our workers, and then those other persons who are making contributions. Our workers in the sense that they have been able to make some sacrifice, allowing us to effect a little downward review on the salaries that we are paying, so that we can afford to also have funds available to tackle some of these other challenges that affects every other data. And to that extent, we owe them a lot of gratitude. And so as a government, we are determined to carry on alongside, then also at the same time, carrying our people along for them to understand where we are at any given time.
All right. Thank you so very much, Commissioner for Information, Delta State, Charles Aniago, for your contributions. And do keep safe out there too.
Thank you.